The heat is sweltering. Out in the field, there's little shelter from the burning sun. Peter Angelo and his wife, Abouk Majak, diligently harvest their crop by hand. Each and every grain is important. This field is their main source of income. We've hardly had any rain this year, and therefore the harvest has failed badly. There's simply not enough crop, and some of it is rotten. Without support, we don't have enough to eat. Luca Quach works for the German aid organization Welthungerhilfe. He regularly comes to Awale West to check on the living conditions for local residents. Mostly, it's bad news. Like Peter in a book, many here have lost their crops.
And what I've seen inside is not enough. This will take a family of 7 people from now up to April, and thereafter they will not be having any food in the stock again. So they will be starting hunting for other means of how to get food, which is very difficult here because the prices for food commodities is very high, and besides, they are not available in the market.
Many products used to come from neighboring Kenya and Uganda, but since the start of the civil war, the supply roads have closed. With no food on sale, the local market is all but deserted. The few items here are more like treasures on display in a museum. It's food that Peter and Abouk can no longer afford. And as if the drought wasn't enough, residents say the security situation in the war-torn country makes finding supplies even more difficult. I used to go to the forest every day to gather firewood and edible roots, but it's no longer safe here. I can't go to the market anymore to buy firewood. Here too, we are affected by the conflict. In July, we were attacked by rebel forces. They stole cows and goats and took some of our other possessions. They caused chaos. Then they disappeared back into the bush, but we are afraid that they're still out there. The situation in South Sudan is dire, a seemingly endless civil war and a threat of famine. The world's youngest country faces a difficult future.